Hey guys, can you hear me? All of you? Just confirm. I think you guys should be hearing me now. Please tell me if the audio and everything is fine. Sorry for the delay on my side today. Okay, all good. Sorry for the delay on my end today. I was here at 10 p.m. as you all know, but there was a slight delay in getting the stream key. तो पहले मुझे लगा नहीं मिलेगी. एक spelling सही कर देते हैं, नहीं तो तुम लोग मजाक उड़ाओगे. Right. Okay. So hello all of you. How are all of you doing? कैसी रही तुम लोगों की होली? How was holi for all of you? What did you guys do? बताओ मेरे को. तब तक फिर हम शुरू करते हैं उसके बाद. हाय पूजा, हाय ईशानी, हाय प्रिंस, हाय विद्या, हाय तनिष्का, हाउ आर यू? हाउ वॉज योर होली फॉर ऑल ऑफ यू? इट वेंट गुड. आई होप एवरी वन इज फाइन, नोबडी इज हर्ट. फैंटास्टिक, ग्रेट 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 टू नो. ओके, सो एज यू नो वी आर बैक विद फाइव लाइन्स ऑफ एनसीईआरटी इन फाइव लाइन्स. एंड लास्ट वीक जस्ट बिफोर होली वी फिनिश्ड विद द टॉपिक ऑफ प्लांट फिजियोलॉजी. वी डिड ऑल फाइव चैप्टर्स. एंड आफ्टर दैट आई एम मूविंग ऑन टू ह्यूमन फिजियोलॉजी. ओके, आई एम मूविंग ऑन टू ह्यूमन फिजियोलॉजी. दैट इज द नेक्स्ट topic in your NCERT from class 11, and we are doing the first chapter, that is digestion and absorption. I am from Tamil Nadu, so no holi. Okay, that is nice. My holi was wonderful. Okay, I had almost slept. Uske baad mere batchmates aaye, mere ko neend se unhone uthaya, aur uske baad mere room ke bahar na sade hue wo pade the santre, you know, santre orange. सो देवर ऑरेंजेस, सो वो ऑरेंजेस फिर उन्होंने मेरे पे लगा दिए. दैट इज़ हाउ इट वेंट. एंड ऐसा था मेरा एक्सपीरियंस बेसिकली. सो या दैट वॉज अबाउट इट. हाँ यार, क्वेश्चन असर्शन रीजन के बेस पे अभी मैं भेजना रह गया. काफ़ी कुछ हो जाता है करने को एक्चुअली. सो आई जस्ट ट्राई टू मेक श्योर दैट वी डू इट नेक्स्ट टाइम, है ना? ओके, वंडरफुल. ठीक है, हाय धरा, हाय बीना. चलो ओके, लेट्स स्टार्ट. आई होप यू गाइस हैव वॉच्ड यस्टरडे सेशन, एंड इफ यू वुड हैव सीन माय सेशन ऑन एनटीए'स ऑफिशियल अपडेट ऑन नीट सिलेबस, यू वुड हैव सीन दैट जो लोग बोल रहे हैं कि सिलेबस रैशनलाइज हो गया है, उसमें दिस इज वन ऑफ द चैप्टर्स विच आई फाइंड टू बी वेरी फनी. ओके, बिकॉज पीपल आर सेइंग कि ये चैप्टर एनसीईआरटी ने ड्रॉप कर दिया, राइट? दिस विल नॉट कम इन नीट. But that is very funny because you are going to come to MBBS. Digestion and absorption is the basis of your gastroenterology. It will come in your first year, second year, final year. तो अगर तुम्हें digestion and absorption के basics नहीं पता होंगे तो you cannot do MBBS. Okay? So it is not possible कि NEET से ऐसे chapters को वो हटा दे, right? And if you would have seen this video, मैंने इस video में with the information bulletin of NEET 2023. I have shown you that there is no reduction in syllabus for NEET. This chapter will 100% be coming. If you haven't watched this video, you guys can go ahead and watch it. It was uploaded on 8th March regarding the syllabus. ठीक है? No herbal gulal, direct natural color from fruits. यार वो fruit भी सड़ा हुआ fruit था ना? It wasn't healthy fruit. That fruit was also, you know, smelling like anything. Okay? Do genetics next. ठीक है? So you guys can subscribe to the Telegram channel if you haven't already. As you know, I keep updating the schedule, PDF and all of this on the Telegram channel itself. So if you guys haven't subscribed, you guys can go ahead and subscribe to the Telegram channel. So let's quickly begin with the first line. So as my promise to all of you is, Hi Akansha, hi Himbala, how are you? Good evening to both of you. As my promise to all of you is that we will pick up 5 lines from NCERT, and those 5 lines will be extremely high yield, and you can be very confident that 70 to 75% chances are there that a question in the examination will be from these 5 slides itself. Okay? Acha. So those of you who don't know who I am, my name is Chaitanya Mittal. I'm currently a final prof MBBS at AIIMS New Delhi. I cracked the AIIMS entrance in 2019 where I had an All India rank of 4, and I am the blue biology teacher, your biology educator on Unacademy NEET Express. ठीक है, महाकाल तो सोने जा रहे हैं लग रहा है. ओके, लेट्स स्टार्ट विदाउट वेस्टिंग एनी मोर टाइम. एंड द फर्स्ट थिंग दैट यू हैव टू नो, एंड यू ऑल नो, कि मैं ये 5 लाइनें क्यों चुनता हूँ. वाई डू आई टेक दीज 5 लाइन्स ओनली? बिकॉज यू कैन सी दिस वॉज आस्क्ड इन नीट 2018, दिस वॉज आस्क्ड इन नीट 2017, 2015 एंड 2011. सो यू कैन सी दैट दिस इज अगेन वन ऑफ द एग्जामिनर्स वेरी फेवरेट टॉपिक्स, एंड दिस गिव्स यू एन इनसाइट इन टू द एग्जामिनर्स माइंड. दैट एग्जामिनर जब ये चैप्टर खोलता है क्वेश्चन डालने के लिए, सो विच टॉपिक्स डज ही लाइक, विच टॉपिक्स डज ही लाइक टू आस्क क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम, राइट, ही और शी. So that is the mindset that you have to get into, and I am going to help you to do that. ठीक है, and every chapter can be summarized in 5 lines. ठीक है, एकदम जैसे बच्चे को पढ़ाते हैं, बिल्कुल वो है मेरा goal कि तुम्हें इतना simplify कर दूँ मैं that you can ultimately tell anyone that I know this chapter and I can tell it to you in 5 lines. Okay, start करें. Right. So the first point. So as you all know, digestion absorption is everything related to your alimentary canal and associated organs. Okay, so your alimentary canal starts from your mouth, from your buccal cavity, right, and it goes right till your anus from anterior to posterior. All right. Okay, now in the mouth you have teeth, and the teeth are a very special gift to mammals. Okay, if you look at birds, right, and if you look at reptiles, if you look at snakes, do they have teeth? Do birds have teeth? Do snakes have teeth? You guys tell me. Okay, so you all know snakes do have some homodont dentition, right? That is why they are having fangs. Hai na? So snakes, they have homodont dentition. That is why they have fangs, right? What about birds? You guys all know birds don't have much, right? So in that sense, mammals are very special that we have some special kind of teeth. इसीलिए आप लोगों को पता होगा कि जैसे MBBS होती है, वैसे BDS is a complete different course. It is a completely separate 5.5 year course, right? Because your teeth are in themselves such an important structure that they have a complete course dedicated to it. आप सोचो, हम MBBS कर रहे हैं जिसमें हम 19 subject पढ़ रहे हैं, right, so many systems, but your teeth have a complete different course dedicated to them. Okay, so there must be a lot about the teeth, but these are the 5 points that will give you a lot of clarity and have been frequently asked. So there are 3 characters of teeth that you must remember. The first character is human teeth are heterodont. That means we have 4 different types of teeth. You all know this, 4 different types. Okay, I told you snakes were homodont. They have only one type of teeth. They do not have separate incisors, canines, premolars, molars, right? They have only one type of teeth. Yes, birds have their jaw modified into the beak. That is absolutely true, right? That is not false. That is correct. That understanding is correct. Okay, so that is the first thing, that all the 32 teeth, they are not similar. ठीक है, okay. Second, humans are diphyodont, and as you all know, we have two sets of teeth. Okay, तो जब छोटा बच्चा होता है, they get their first set of teeth, and then around the age of 5-6 years, the teeth fall down, and then you get another set. Okay, that is why you have the whole concept of tooth fairy, है ना? टूथ फेरी. तो फॉरेन में क्या होता है, जब बच्चे का दांत गिरता है ना, तो उसको गिफ्ट मिलता है, राइट. इंडिया में क्या होता है, बच्चे का दांत गिरता है, बच्चा रोता है, उसको थप्पड़ पड़ता है, राइट. सो वहां पे टूथ फेरी है, यहाँ पे टूथ पे स्लैप है. ठीक है, डिफरेंट डिफरेंट कॉन्सेप्ट, जैसा देश वैसा काम, राइट? सो डायफायोडोंट मीन्स यू हैव टू सेट्स ऑफ टीथ. टू सेट्स मीन्स देर इज अ टेम्पररी सेट एंड देर इज अ परमानेंट सेट. ओके, एंड वन थिंग दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, दैट इज थीकोडोंट डेंटिशन. दैट इज वेरी वेरी स्पेशल. थीकोडोंट डेंटिशन इज एन एक्सक्लूसिव कैरेक्टर ऑफ मैमल्स, राइट? थीकोडोंट, इट मीन्स दैट द टीथ दे आर एम्बेडेड, द टीथ दे आर एम्बेडेड इन टू द जॉ सॉकेट. दे आर एम्बेडेड इन टू द जॉ सॉकेट, राइट? टीथ आर एम्बेडेड इन द जॉ सॉकेट, सो दे डू नॉट फॉल ऑफ ईजिली, है ना? बहुत जोर से मुक्का मारोगे तभी दांत गिरेगा. ओके, यू हैव टू हिट वेरी हार्ड टू ब्रेक अ टीथ. ओके, बिकॉज दे आर एम्बेडेड इन टू द जॉ सॉकेट, है ना? जॉ के अंदर एक सॉकेट बना हुआ है, उसके अंदर दांत है, राइट? यू माइट हैव सीन दिस डायग्राम वेर यू नो द टीथ हैज अ क्राउन, इट हैज दीज रूट्स, राइट? सो दिस इज एम्बेडेड विद इट्स रूट्स इन द जॉ सॉकेट. इज दैट क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू? दैट इज द थर्ड पॉइंट. नाउ नाउ द कॉन्सेप्ट कम्स ऑफ डेंटल फॉर्मूला. द नाउ द कॉन्सेप्ट कम्स ऑफ डेंटल फॉर्मूला, ठीक है? सो हाउ मेनी टीथ डज एन अडल्ट हैव? इट इज वेरी इजी टू रिमेंबर, इट इज कॉल्ड बत्तीसी. क्या बोलते हैं? बत्तीसी. एंड वॉट डज बत्तीसी हैव? बत्तीसी इज बत्तीस, राइट? बत्तीस मीन्स 32, ठीक है? सो जस्ट ब्रेक डाउन दिस वर्ड, इट्स अ हिंदी वर्ड इफ यू आर अवेयर. सो 32 सेट ऑफ टीथ इन अडल्ट्स. ओके, नाउ आउट ऑफ दीज 32, आउट ऑफ दीज 32 व्हाट हैपेंस, जस्ट ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड. सो लेट्स फर्स्ट टॉक अबाउट अडल्ट. ओके, सो व्हाट इज द डेंटल फॉर्मूला? डेंटल फॉर्मूला इज रिप्रेजेंटेड एज यू ड्रॉ अ लाइन एंड यू राइट डाउन द incisors, the canines, the premolars and the molars. In this order you write it down, theek hai? So for adults these 32 are 2 1 2 3. Okay, you write on upper jaw and lower jaw one half. Okay, and the other half is automatically understood that it will be symmetrical, that it will be symmetrical. So here you will write 2 1 2 3. Okay, 2 1 2 3. So there are two incisors, one canine, two premolars and three molars in one quadrant of the jaw. Okay, similarly below you have the same and on the opposite side you have the same. So basically this multiplied by 2 is the number that you get. Okay, why do you write separately for the upper jaw and lower jaw? Because that is not necessarily symmetrical. See, upper jaw and lower jaw will be symmetrical. Just give me 1 second, guys. Right, as I was saying, the upper jaw and the lower jaw are not necessarily symmetrical. The left and the right are definitely symmetrical. इसीलिए हम ऊपर और नीचे का अलग अलग लिखते हैं. Okay? Now if I ask you a question, okay? Now if I ask you a question, what about a 17-year-old? What will happen in a 17-year-old adult? Can you tell me the dental formula for a 17-year-old adult? If you are given the age in the question as 17-year-old, what will be the dental formula? I'll talk about milk teeth, don't worry. I'll talk about milk teeth, do not worry. So for a 17-year-old, what is the dental formula? So remember, this last wisdom tooth is actually a molar, is actually a wisdom tooth. Okay, it comes after 18 years of age and it causes a lot of trouble. Okay, so in a 17-year-old, this teeth is not present. So you will generally have 2 1 2 2. You will generally have 2 1 2 2, which means 1 is less, -1, right? -1. I have a wisdom tooth and it is frankly in a very horrible position. It is teda hua pada hai wo, basically. You know, horizontal teeth, they are impacted teeth basically. So what is happening in my teeth is that I have seen the x-ray, and if I show you the x-ray, you guys will be scared ki ye kya hai. So this is my second last molar. And if you look at my last molar, it is like this. This is how the x-ray looks like. So the teeth is horizontally impacted. Okay, so this is my wisdom tooth. So I'll probably have to get it removed at some point. But till the time it doesn't trouble, we don't do anything about it. Okay? Because I am now almost 22, about to turn 23 this year. Right? So what is the dental formula for me? It is 2 1 2 3. What is the dental formula for a student who is giving NEET? It is 2 1 2 2. Theek hai? Understood?
एजुकेटर का डेंटल फॉर्मूला क्या है 2123, और बच्चे का डेंटल फॉर्मूला क्या है 2122। एंड एकदम छोटा बच्चा जो है हु इज अराउंड 5-6 ईयर्स ओल्ड एंड हैज द कंप्लीट सेट ऑफ टेम्पररी टीथ, व्हाट इज द डेंटल फॉर्मूला? इट इज 2102 बिकॉज दे डू नॉट हैव एनी प्री मोलर्स। ओके, प्री मोलर्स आर एबसेंट इन टेम्पररी टीथ, प्री मोलर्स आर एबसेंट इन टेम्पररी टीथ। ओके, सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट सेट और द टेम्पररी सेट और द मिल्क टीथ। ओके, और द मिल्क टीथ, राइट? 2102, प्री मोलर्स आर एबसेंट। नाउ इफ आई लुक एट द अडल्ट, इट इज 2123, इट इज द 2123। सो इट कैन बी आस्क्ड टू यू, इन ह्यूमंस विच सेट ऑफ टीथ आर मोनोफायोडोंट, दैट मीन्स दे कम ओनली वंस इन द लाइफ टाइम। ओके, सो विच इज द फॉर्मूला फॉर दैट? सी, दिस इज देयर इन चाइल्ड एंड अडल्ट बोथ, दीज आर मोनोफायोडोंट एंड वन मोलर इज मोनोफायोडोंट। सो फॉर्मूला फॉर दैट विल बी 0012 डिवाइडेड बाय 0012, ये डिवाइडेड बाय नहीं है, बेसिकली अपॉन है ना, राइट? सो दिस इज द डेंटल फॉर्मूला फॉर मोनोफायोडोंट टीथ, जस्ट इन केस अ हायर ऑर्डर क्वेश्चन इज आस्क्ड टू यू। ओके, नाउ यू कैन हैव अ लुक एट दिस, ऑल विल बी वेरी सिंपल टू यू, आई हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन्ड थीकोडोंट, डायफायोडोंट, हेटेरोडोंट, अडल्ट फॉर्मूला, इन्फेंट फॉर्मूला, एंड आई हैव टोल्ड यू एन एक्स्ट्रा फॉर्मूला फॉर अ नीट एस्पायरेंट, दैट इज 2122 अपॉन 2122। ठीक है, आई होप यू कैन रिमेम्बर। सो दीज आर द इनसाइजर्स, the canines, the premolars and the molars. Okay, so premolars have two roots while molars have three roots, and this is the socket of jaw in which they are embedded. Clear? This is the end of the first point that is related to your dentition and teeth. Clear to all of you? Any doubts anyone has, please let me know. Okay, there are other things also that are, you know, out of NCRT. What is bunodont? Bunodont means there are blunt cusps और दी एलिवेशन ऑफ टूथ इज इन दैट वे। ठीक है, जब हम पढ़ते थे तो स्टेट पीएमटी के कुछ पॉइंट्स बताए जाते थे टू अस, लाइक द यू विल फाइंड देम इन माय शॉर्ट नोट्स। ओके, आई विल टेल यू सम एक्स्ट्रा पॉइंट्स दैट यू विल फाइंड इन माय शॉर्ट नोट्स, यू डोंट नीड टू नो देम। ठीक है, मैं बताऊंगा मेरी, तो आई नो द डेंटल फॉर्मूला फॉर एलिफेंट। व्हाई इज इट इंपॉर्टेंट? बिकॉज टस्क्स आर प्रेजेंट इन एलिफेंट। सो इन एन एलिफेंट इट इज एक्चुअली 1003 divided by 0003, because an elephant has tusks on the upper jaw only. Okay, so you can see that this is different from this. It is not necessary that upper and lower jaw formula will be same. Okay, but you don't need to remember, I'm just showing you the importance of dental formula. Okay, similarly if you look at rabbit, it is 2033 divided by 1023, so it is different in upper and lower jaw. It can be different, okay, there is no problem with it being different. Yeah, so I'll tell you what I did for INBO. If you, anybody of you wants to crack INBO, so my goal would be ki class 11 mein you prepare for NSEB very well. And how you can do that is, do the 5-year previous year question of NSEB, right? If anybody wants to target biology Olympiad, because I love biology, and do Campbell. Okay, do Campbell. It usually occurs in November, so most of your class 11 syllabus is already covered. You should do 3 chapters from here. Okay, one you should do genetics, the second you should do ecology, and third there is a chapter on animal behavior that is not asked in NEET, that is called ethology. So these 3 chapters you can do for biology Olympiad. Okay, but this is only for those students who are preparing for biology Olympiad, not for NEET aspirants. Okay, extra hai ye, sabko karne ki zarurat nahi hai, sirf jinko meri tarah zyada chul hai wo log kar sakte hai. Theek hai Veena, till what time will you take class? I'll try to finish up by 11. Okay, that should be the maximum. Nahi to your parents will also say ki ye kaun sa educator hai jo raat ke 12 baje tak padha raha hai, hai na? Okay. No, Tabish, no need to learn formula for elephant, rabbit or anything. Bilkul bhul jao usko. Maine wo slide hi delete kar di hai. Okay. So this is all you need to remember. Ye bhi bahut zyada hai. Okay. Hi Pushpendu, good evening. Hi Jagat Singh, how are you? INBO is India National Biology Olympiad. Okay, life watch, theek hai. Now, let's come to this question on stomach and its mucosa. Question number 2, matlab second point from NCRT that you need to remember. Second point from NCRT that you need to remember. So we have done with the first point. Now you can again see why I have picked up these points. You can see it was asked in 2021, 2018, 2016, 2015 में एक नीट का एग्जाम हुआ था जो कैंसिल हो गया था बिकॉज ऑफ पेपर लीक, है ना. तो इफ यू रिमेंबर दिस वॉज अ वेरी बैड टाइम फॉर नीट, है ना. 2014 में नीट दो बार हुआ है, 2015 में दो बार हुआ है, 2016 में भी दो बार हुआ है. सो दिस वॉज अ टाइम वेन नीट वॉज देर वॉज सम और दी अदर प्रॉब्लम गोइंग ऑन इन नीट. ओके, सो दैट वॉज अ वेरी बैड टाइम फॉर नीट, बट नाउ थिंग्स आर रिलेटिवली मच बेटर. ओके, सो 2021, 2018, 2016, 2015. सो द ट्रेंड इट इज आस्ट ऑलमोस्ट एवरी थ्री ईयर्स, है ना. सो दैट इज द अप्रॉक्सीमेट ट्रेंड ऑफ बींग आस्ट ऑलमोस्ट एवरी थ्री ईयर्स. सो दिस कैन बी अगेन आस्ट इन नीट 2024 और 2023, है ना. इट कैन कम, यू नेवर नो. दैट इज वाई आई हैव kept this point. Even long marathon sessions are more interactive and learning. ठीक है, मैंने एक मैराथन सेशन प्लान किया है, अगर तुम लोग अटेंड करोगे तो मैं करूँगा. सो बेसिकली वॉट आई विल डू इज आई हैव माई ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री शॉर्ट नोट्स. आई नो अ लॉट ऑफ यू फेस अ लॉट ऑफ ट्रबल इन ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री. ठीक है, आई विल नॉट बी एबल टू एक्सप्लेन मच, बट आई हैव 50 नेम रिएक्शंस that if you do these 50 name reactions, I can assure you that out of your 15 questions, 7 questions will come from those name reactions. Karna hai tum logon ko ye, it will take 3 to 4 hours and we can do this. Theek hai, to name reactions are, trust me, the single most important topic of organic chemistry, but no one teaches them, no one, frankly no one teaches them. Haan, we can do it on Sunday. ओके, चलो तुम लोगों ने थम्स अप दे दिया. मैं आई विल कंफर्म कि संडे को मेरा शेड्यूल कैसा है, ठीक है, एंड आई विल लेट यू नो. अरे ये तो किसी का कॉल आ रहा है मुझे, एक सेकेंड रिप्लाई कर दूं, बुरा तो नहीं मान जाओगे. ठीक है, so now coming to the second point that is very very important for NCERT, let's start. Okay, stomach. So stomach has, so as you know in GI you have four layers, mucosa, submucosa, muscularis and serosa, right? So these are the four layers like this, and the innermost layer is called mucosa. This is the innermost layer. Okay, now mucosa, it has glands because it has to release secretions into the lumen. So mucosa has glands. Now in stomach, as you see, stomach is called gastric, you know, gastric is the word used for stomach. So mucosa of stomach has gastric glands. Okay, and gastric glands have three major types of cells. Okay, now see, what does stomach release? Stomach releases, as you all know, it releases HCl, that is the acid. Then it releases enzyme for digesting of proteins, which is pepsinogen, right? And to protect from HCl, it has to release mucus. It has to release three things, okay? HCl, pepsinogen and mucus. So to release these three things, it needs appropriate glands, okay? So first you have HCl release, है ना. HCl is released by special cells called as auxintic cells or parietal cells. They are responsible for release of HCl. ठीक है, now why are they responsible for release of HCl? Why are auxintic cells or parietal cells responsible for release of HCl? Because they have pumps for release of protons and chlorides. ठीक है, that is not important for you. What is important for you is they also release intrinsic factor, that is Cassel's intrinsic factor. They release a factor that helps in absorption of vitamin 2. They release an intrinsic factor, Cassel's intrinsic factor, which is responsible for vitamin B12 absorption. Okay, just remember this point additionally. Next, pepsinogen. So pepsinogen is the main enzyme, hai na, bilkul main enzyme hai ye. So isiliye the cells are called as chief cells. They are the main cells. So they are called as chief cells, right? Or zymogen means enzyme. Zymogen means enzyme. They are enzyme releasing cells, also called as peptic cells, right? Pepsin. Hai na, pepsin se aaya naam peptic. Okay. Finally, you have mucus releasing cells, and they are present at the neck of the gland. So they are called as mucus neck cells. Why are they called neck cells? Because they are present at the neck of the gland. Okay, and they release bicarbonate. Hai na? HCO3-. Theek hai? So that is the whole concept about stomach. Now, what about intestine? So in stomach you have mucosa by mucus neck cells, but in intestine you have something different. In intestine you have mucus cells called as goblet cells. Theek hai, goblet cells hai hamare paas intestine mein along with your other cells. Okay, so there are special cells called as goblet cells. So these goblet cells are responsible for release of mucus. Theek hai, so in intestine you have special cells called as goblet cells. Okay, along with that, intestinal cells, they release other enzymes and juice. So if you all know, there is a word called as entericus, and enteric means intestine, hai na? Enteric means intestine. Okay, so sucus entericus means the juice of the intestine, which includes all enzymes, mucus, etc. Okay, it means juice of the intestine. That is the meaning of sucus entericus. Okay, now let's quickly read the paragraph. So stomach has three types of glands: mucus neck cells, peptic cells or chief cells, and parietal or oxyntic cells. Theek hai? And you can see what they are releasing. So mucus, pepsinogen, HCl and intrinsic factor that is essential for absorption of vitamin B12. Okay, next. Intestinal epithelium has goblet cells which secrete mucus. The secretions of the brush border cells of the mucosa along with secretions of the goblet cells continues the intestinal juice, sucus entericus. And what are the enzymes in the intestinal juice? You have disaccharidases, dipeptidases, lipases, nucleosidases. तो इंटेस्टाइन की जो भी एंजाइम्स होती हैं मोस्टली, ओके, सो इंटेस्टाइन, इफ यू लुक एट इंटेस्टाइन, इट इज हैविंग सीलिएटेड एपिथेलियम, इट इज हैविंग दीज स्मॉल विलाय, माइक्रो विलाय प्रेजेंट, राइट? सो इस ब्रश बॉर्डर से देर आर सर्टन एंजाइम्स विच ब्रेक डाउन इंटू फाइनल प्रोडक्ट्स, इंटू फाइनल अब्सॉर्बेबल फॉर्म्स. ओके, सो इट विल ब्रेक डाउन वेरी स्मॉल मॉलिक्यूल्स, ओके, लाइक डायसेक्राइड्स, डायपेप्टाइड्स. Okay, so it will break them into monomers. And now we have already done the chapter of biomolecules, so you will understand this better. Theek hai? And the mucus along with bicarbonates protect from the pancreas. Theek hai? So pancreas also gives bicarbonates. Theek hai? So what NCRT is trying to say is, that this is your pancreas. This mucus to protect itself, and pancreas is releasing what? Pancreas is giving you bicarbonate. So this mucus and bicarbonate is protecting you. From acid and providing you an alkaline medium. Okay, submucosal glands that are Brunner's gland also help in mucus secretion. Okay, so Dhamma is saying, ek baar repeat kar do intestine wala. Okay, you've understood this stomach wala. Okay, let me repeat the intestine wala. Okay, so now what your NCRT is trying to convey is, this is your intestine. This is the mucus. Okay, sorry, this is your mucosa. This layer is your mucosa. And this here below is your submucosa. Theek hai, this is your mucosa. This is your submucosa. Now in the mucosa you have enterocytes, okay, and in between you have some special cells called as goblet cells. Now these goblet cells release mucus, and these enterocytes which have brush border, they release enzymes to digest small molecules like maltose, right, like dipeptides and all of this. Theek hai? ठीक है. नाउ देयर कंबाइंड सिक्रीशन, देयर कंबाइंड सिक्रीशन इज कॉल्ड सुकस एंटेरिकस, दैट इज द जूस ऑफ द इंटेस्टाइन विच इज अराउंड 1 to 2 liters पर डे. NCERT also says that in the submucosa you have some special glands which remember are only present in the duodenum. Okay, submucosal glands, Brunner glands are only present in the duodenum and they also help in release of mucus. Now your NCERT says that pancreas also helps. Okay, so this is your, let's say I've drawn pancreas. So pancreas releases bicarbonate. And together the mucus and bicarbonate, they are helping in maintaining an alkaline environment and protecting the GI. Okay, that is the complete funda. This is now the complete funda that you guys have to remember. Okay, hi Alfia, how are you? Good evening. Raw peanuts, you've turned on notifications but you still don't get notifications. ये तो यार YouTube को ही कंप्लेन करनी पड़ेगी, इसका सोल्यूशन तो बहुत मुश्किल है. राइट, नाउ लेट्स कम टू द थर्ड पॉइंट दैट इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. इट हैज अगेन बीन रिपीटेडली आस्क्ड इन नीट 2021, नीट 2020, नीट 2017, 2015. सो यू कैन अगेन सी दिस हैज बीन आस्क्ड एवरी 2 years, एवरी 3 years. सो वेरी हाई प्रोबेबिलिटी दैट दिस विल बी आस्क्ड इन नीट 2023. ओके, इज दैट क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू? So you can see that I have chosen 5 points which are very very high yield. Okay, altu faltu point nahi choose kiya humne. Hi Lone, hi Alfia, how are you? Yeah, you should know the difference between villi and microvilli. It is nothing. Villi are the big folds and microvilli are the small brush border that is present on the intestine. So these are the villi which are folds and these microfolds are basically your microvilli. There isn't much to understand. It's just a visualization. Okay, now coming to the third point that has been asked. So now here you are being talked about all the juices that the intestine receives, hai na? So in the previous slide we mentioned a little bit about pancreas. So remember, intestine, that is, let's say this is the duodenum. So duodenum receives bile from the liver and gallbladder, right? And from the pancreas, it gets pancreatic juice and it has its own secretion that is sucus entericus. So in the duodenum, you are having three things. One is the intestinal secretions. The second is the secretions of the liver and gallbladder, that is your bile. And third, you have a juice from the pancreas that is called as pancreatic juice. So there are three secretions that are mixing in the duodenum and they are carrying out all the process of digestion, almost everything that the stomach has not done, they have to do, right? Okay. So various types of movements are generated by the muscularis layer. As you know that the third layer is the muscle, right? And muscle will be responsible for peristalsis and churning movements, okay? So due to these movements, there is mixing up of food with the juice. Hai na? Jaise hum ghar pe mixi chalate hai, to wo मिक्स कर देता है उसको अच्छे से. सो दिस मस्क्यूलैरिस, ड्यू टू द मूवमेंट, द जूसेस, द सिक्रीशंस विल मिक्स विद द फूड. ओके, एंड व्हाट आर द थ्री सिक्रीशंस? द बाइल जूस, द पैंक्रियाटिक जूस एंड द इंटेस्टाइनल जूस आर द सिक्रीशंस इन द स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन. ओके, पैंक्रियाटिक जूस एंड बाइल जूस आर रिलीज्ड थ्रू अ कॉमन डक्ट कॉल्ड एज द हिपैटो पैंक्रियाटिक डक्ट. सो दिस डक्ट, दिस कॉमन डक्ट इज कॉल्ड हिपैटो pancreatic duct because it is giving secretions from hepato means liver and pancreas obviously means pancreas. So hepatopancreatic duct. Now what are the contents in pancreatic juice? That is very very important. It has six contents. Please remember, six contents in pancreatic juice. So please write down six contents of pancreatic juice. They are very important to remember. Six contents of pancreatic juice. ठीक है, लिखे साथ साथ. Will you guys be able to write components of pancreatic juice? Come on. Okay. So pancreas, it has to digest mainly three things. It has to digest all three things. That is carbohydrate, fat, and protein. Okay. So carbohydrate, as you know, in the saliva, in the salivary gland, you had salivary amylase. Similarly, pancreas releases an enzyme called as pancreatic amylase, right? For fat, it is the main organ, right? For fat, it is the main organ, so it releases pancreatic lipase. It releases pancreatic lipase. Okay? It releases pancreatic lipase. Then it has to digest proteins. So for proteins, it releases three important enzymes. One is trypsinogen, one is trypsinogen. Okay? The other is called chymotrypsinogen, chymotrypsinogen. And to cleave the carboxy end, it releases an enzyme called as carboxypeptidase. Carboxypeptidase. Three enzymes, right? So now this is total of five. This is one, two, three, four, five, right? And these are three, so this is five, right? Now the sixth one is for the digestion of nucleic acids, right? Nucleases. So it digests DNA and RNA. So what are the enzymes? Trypsinogen, chymotrypsinogen, procarboxypeptidase, amylase, and lipase. Okay? Now see what will happen is it has powerful enzymes which can digest proteins. Okay? So these enzymes are secreted in the inactive form. This gen means it is in the inactive form. Right, gen means it is in the inactive form. So to activate them, so to activate trypsinogen, you actually have so that it is activated only when it enters the intestine. Intestine releases an enzyme called as enterokinase. It releases an enzyme called as enterokinase that activates trypsinogen to trypsin. Right, that activates trypsinogen to trypsin, and then trypsin activates all other enzymes. Trypsin activates all other enzymes. ठीक है, so that is the funda. So now you can read the trypsinogen is activated by an enzyme enterokinase. Enterokinase activates trypsinogen. Okay, which in turn activates the other enzymes in the pancreatic juice. Okay, and now last thing, what is the content of the bile? What is the content of the bile? So this is very very important to remember. There are two main components of bile. There are only two main components of bile. One is bile salts and one is bile pigments. Bile salts and bile pigments. There are no enzymes. There are no enzymes in bile. There are no enzymes in bile. That is very, very important for all of you to remember. There are no enzymes in bile. ठीक है? So what does bile have? Bile pigments. There are two bile pigments, bilirubin and biliverdin, right? Bile salts, and apart from that, there are certain lipids like cholesterol and phospholipids, but no enzymes. And what is the function of bile? Bile helps in the emulsification of fats. That means it increases the surface area for fat digestion, breakdown of fat into small, small micelles so that surface area is increased for action of lipases. Bile also activates lipases. They together open into the duodenum as hepatopancreatic duct, and the sphincter that guards this duct is called sphincter of Oddi. Okay, I've heard that in cow reverse peristalsis can occur. Yes, so in cows there is a phenomenon called as rumination. So what they do is regurgitation, right? So what happens is the food goes to the stomach, it comes back to the mouth so that they can chew it later. That is called rumination. That is why they are called ruminants. So reverse peristalsis can in fact also occur in humans in some scenarios. Okay, bile is for emulsification of fat, so it means it is very, very important for activation of lipases. It is important for breakdown of fats into smaller particles that can be digested. Okay, so if you remove bile, completely remove bile, then fat will not be digested. Okay, but you might have heard that we can remove the gallbladder. Gallbladder can be removed because the function of gallbladder is to store and concentrate bile. It does not release bile because liver will still be releasing bile. So you can safely remove the gallbladder. Because even if bile is not concentrated, some digestion of fat will still happen. And if gallbladder is becoming problematic because of stones, gallbladder can be removed. Okay, but gallbladder is not an appendix. It is not like appendix. It is not a vestigial organ. Okay, so if you remove bile, there will be no digestion of fat, even though it does not have any enzyme. ठीक है? Now, last point is the summary of absorption. So as you know, the chapter is called digestion and absorption. So I have covered most of the points related to digestion. You know, I have covered the teeth, I have covered the stomach, I have covered the intestine, I have covered the pancreas, I have covered the liver and gallbladder. So much we have covered in just three slides. That was almost everything that you need to know about digestion. Now coming to the third point, that is absorption. The fourth point, that is now related to absorption. So again, you can see these questions were again very frequently asked 3 years, then next year, then again 4-5 years ke baad. So this can again be a question in your examination about absorption, and there is a very simple table in NCERT that you can remember. Yeah, I'll definitely post these PDFs, don't worry, you don't have to write anything. मैं थोड़ा एक दो दिन से पोस्ट नहीं कर पाया था, बट डेफिनेटली आई विल पोस्ट दीज वंस नाउ. ओके, नाउ सो यू कैन रिमेंबर मोस्ट ऑफ द एब्जॉर्प्शन हैपेंस इन द स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन. ऑलमोस्ट 80-90% ऑफ द एब्जॉर्प्शन हैपेंस इन स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन. ठीक है, सो इट इज द प्रिंसिपल ऑर्गन फॉर एब्जॉर्प्शन ऑफ न्यूट्रिएंट्स. डाइजेशन इज कंप्लीटेड हियर एंड फाइनल प्रोडक्ट्स ऑफ डाइजेशन सच एज ग्लूकोज, फ्रक्टोज, फैटी एसिड, ग्लिसरॉल, अमीनो एसिड आर एब्जॉर्ब थ्रू द mucosa into the bloodstream and lymph. Very, very important, because the fats, the fatty acids are absorbed into lymph. Theek hai? They are absorbed into lymph. Now, what about the other organs? So remember, stomach, very important. There is absorption of alcohol. Some absorption of alcohol occurs in stomach. Okay? So if you are empty stomach and you have alcohol, you should not have alcohol, but this alcohol will be absorbed faster. Okay? Large intestine, absorption of water, some minerals and drugs. Okay, water, some minerals and drugs. Please remember, in summary there used to be a line that most of the absorption of water occurs in large intestine. That is false. Most of the absorption of water occurs in the small intestine. There is no doubt about that. Okay, large intestine, there is absorption of only some water, only some minerals and some drugs. Okay, and what about the mouth? In the mouth, there is absorption of certain drugs, right, on the lower side of the tongue. Okay, and this is used in heart attack. This is very, very important. Okay, this principle is used in heart attack because you have to give the drug fast. You cannot wait for the drug to go to the intestine and be absorbed. So you use some drugs like nitrates, which are kept on the mouth, and they immediately dilate your vessels, and the pain of angina or heart attack is relieved. Okay, so this is very, very important. Mouth is important. This absorption of drugs from the mouth is important in medicine because it helps you to treat a patient with heart attack. Theek hai? Is that clear? That's why this point is very important. Hai na? So this I've explained. Some other points on how transport happens. You all know simple diffusion, facilitated diffusion and active transport. So simple diffusion will be of glucose, amino acid and some electrolytes. Fructose will have facilitated diffusion through a transporter called as GLUT5, through GLUT5, right? What about osmosis? It will be of water and active transport of glucose and amino acids along with sodium. So that is called as a sodium glucose linked transporter. So that is the principle of ORS. That is the principle of ORS. Yes, below the tongue there is a reason, because below the tongue you have a lot of capillaries, you have a lot of blood vessels, and it can easily be absorbed into those blood vessels. That is why you keep it below the tongue. Okay, right. So I was telling you, active transport, how it happens is that you spend ATP, and generally sodium and glucose are taken up together. Sodium and glucose are taken up together. Okay, that is the principle of ORS, oral rehydration solution, in which you have both sodium and glucose, and this sodium and glucose help in the absorption of each other, right? That is why you prefer to give sodium and glucose together. Okay, what about the absorption of fatty acids and glycerol? I already told you that bile converts them to small droplets called micelles. They are absorbed, they move into the small intestine, and there they are formed into protein coated fat globules called chylomicrons. Okay, and then they are transported into the lymph vessels called as lacteals and ultimately released into the bloodstream. So I'll just quickly explain what happens. Okay, so let's say this is your intestine. This is your intestine. So this was your fatty acid. This was your large fatty acid. This was your large fatty acid. So it is first broken down into smaller micelles. It is broken down into smaller micelles. Okay, why? Because it has to be transported across this membrane. So micelles are transported here. Now once micelles come inside, they are coated with proteins. They are coated with proteins. So you add proteins, and this is called as chylomicron. This is called chylomicron. You have the formation of chylomicron. Okay. And here you have vessels called as lacteals. Okay, I'm drawing it with green. These are not blood vessels. These are lacteals, which are lymph vessels. So these chylomicrons go into the lacteals, and from the lacteals, they are transferred to the bloodstream, right? That is how fat is absorbed. That is how fat is absorbed from lumen to blood vessel. Okay. I hope this is clear. With that, we have also covered the fourth point that is very, very important related to absorption. Lots of things to learn here. If you can remember the key points, you will be able to answer any question. Okay. Last point that was asked in NEET 2012 and mains 2010. It hasn't been asked for a long, long time. Okay. And I am just teaching this because it has a lot of clinical relevance. Okay. You should know a little bit about these diseases. What is jaundice? Jaundice is a disease of liver. Okay. You must have heard everything turns yellow. Skin and eyes turn yellow. And why do they turn yellow? Due to bile pigments. What is vomiting? Vomiting is stomach contents come out through mouth. And where is the center for vomiting? It is present in the medulla in the brain. Okay. And what is nausea? Before vomiting, you have a feeling ki ulti aane wali hai. That is called nausea. Is that clear to all of you? What is nausea? Okay. Next, what is diarrhea? You all know what is diarrhea. Abnormal frequency of bowel movement, and becomes more liquid. And when there is diarrhea, there is reduced absorption because everything is going down the feces, right? Constipation is opposite. Too much is being reabsorbed, so feces are retained within the colon. Okay, so less movement. Indigestion means the food is not digested, so you feel like there is a lot of fullness in the stomach. And why does indigestion happen? It can be due to enzyme secretion, it can be due to anxiety, it can be due to food poisoning, it can be due to overeating or spicy food. है ना, इसमें डॉक्टर की वाइब आ जाती है बिल्कुल. Although this chapter, there are very general things. I am sure you all know what is jaundice, vomiting, diarrhea, constipation, indigestion. Very general things, very easy questions to answer. That is probably why the examiner does not ask a lot from here. ठीक है, वो तुमसे ये थोड़ी पूछेगा उल्टी क्या होती है. You all know what is उल्टी, है ना. That is why this part is relatively less important, but it is interesting, it is important to know. What is more interesting is kwashiorkor and marasmus. And it is something that can be asked and is slightly tricky. Kwashiorkor and marasmus. Okay, so just try to grab this concept of kwashiorkor and marasmus. Okay, kwashiorkor and marasmus. ठीक है. So kwashiorkor means only protein deficiency. For a basic understanding, it is only protein deficiency. Calorie intake is fine. Okay, so it means you will get a child who is looking fat. He looks like he has obesity. Okay, his tummy will be protruding, but he will actually be deficient in protein. Okay, because calories are fine, so it does not look like the child is malnourished, but he is actually malnourished. Okay, what about marasmus? Marasmus means bachcha ekdam khatam hai, bachche ne maa ka doodh nahi piya. Okay, that is the problem. Bachche ne maa ka doodh nahi piya. That is why it occurs in children which are less than 1 year of age. Because usse pehle maa ka doodh peena zaruri hai na. Bolte hai na ki aao dekhe kisne maa ka doodh piya hai. So they are actually asking aao dekhe kisko marasmus hai. Right? So children less than 1 year of age, because they did not drink their mother's milk, they did not get calories, that means they did not get adequate carbohydrate, and they did not get protein. So it is a combined deficiency of calorie and protein. So it is more severe. बच्चा एकदम खत्म होगा, एकदम सूखा हुआ होगा. यू विल बी एबल टू सी द बोन्स, यू विल बी एबल टू मेक आउट द टेंडन्स, राइट? देयर विल बी नो फैट. बट इन क्वाशोर्कर यू विल बी एबल टू सी अ प्रोट्रूडिंग बेली. ओके, एंड देयर इज एडिमा. एब्सोल्युटली, व्हाई इज देयर एडिमा? बिकॉज प्रोटीन्स लाइक एल्ब्यूमिन आर मिसिंग. दैट इज व्हाई यू हैव एडिमा. दैट इज द प्रॉब्लम इन क्वाशोर्कर. क्वेश्चन कैसे बनेंगे इस टॉपिक से? प्रिंस इज आस्किंग. सो लॉट्स ऑफ क्वेश्चंस कैन बी आस्क्ड. First question from jaundice can be, which of the following is responsible for jaundice? First option, deposition of bile salts. Second option, deposition of bile pigments. Third option, deposition of cholesterol. Fourth option, deposition of phospholipids. Answer will be deposition of bile pigments. Which of the following organs are affected in jaundice? Liver, stomach, intestine, pancreas. Answer will be liver. Very simple question, unlikely to be asked. Then, Where is the vomit center located in the body? Medulla, pons, midbrain, cerebrum. Answer will be medulla. Answer will be medulla. Diarrhea. There is, what happens to the absorption of food in diarrhea? It is decreased, it is increased, it remains the same, none of these. Answer is, absorption is reduced. Because food is not being absorbed, it is being lost in the bowel movements. Okay, water is not being reabsorbed. Next question. What is the difference between diarrhea and constipation? In diarrhea, you are having excess bowel movement. In constipation, feces are retained. Unlikely to be asked any questions from constipation. Indigestion. Which of the following are not causes of indigestion? First will be inadequate enzyme secretion. Second will be anxiety. Third will be food poisoning. Fourth will be malnutrition. Answer will be malnutrition. Then question on kwashiorkor and marasmus can be there. Which of the following occurs in children less than 1 year of age? Answer options will be kwashiorkor, marasmus, constipation, indigestion. Answer will be marasmus. Okay. Then next question will be kwashiorkor is option A, protein deficiency, option B, protein and calorie deficiency, option C, protein, calorie and fat deficiency, option D, protein, calorie and DNA deficiency. Answer will be protein deficiency unaccompanied by calorie deficiency. Is that clear? I have made so many tricks, so many questions, and maine tumhe isi slide se 6-7 question bana ke dikha diye. This will be one of the questions that will be asked in your examination, and that is the examiner's mindset that you have to know. Okay, so let's quickly revise. As you know, in every session I do this, I do a quick revision of all the points that we have covered in a particular session. Start kare. Acha, how does food poisoning help in indigestion? Or how does food poisoning help me? How does food poisoning cause indigestion? Let's try to understand what is indigestion. Okay, indigestion means food is not getting digested. Food is not getting digested, food is not getting absorbed. Okay, there can be multiple reasons. First, agar aapke paas enzymes nahi hai to food digest nahi hoga. Enzymes nahi hai to food digest nahi hoga. Aapko anxiety ho rahi hai, that means your sympathetic system is activated, your body is not able to function properly. Again, food will not be digested. Theek hai? Similarly, if you have too much spicy food, that will again irritate your stomach. Okay. Same happens with food poisoning. If there is a poison in your food, which means basically there is some kind of an infection or toxin, what will happen is it will damage the intestine. It will damage the intestine. So intestine will not be able to release its sucus enterica properly. It will not be able to absorb the food properly. So that is why in food poisoning, you will have indigestion. And what is the last cause? Overeating. So if you have eaten too much food, your intestine is not able to digest it. So it is too much food, not able to digest, you will feel indigestion. Okay, that is the reason why food poisoning and all of these causes are causing indigestion. Plant anatomy kara do Bhavik in detailed session. Theek hai yaar, abhi na neat se thoda pehle wala time hai, that is why I am doing these short quick sessions, right? Detailed sessions ka time hamare paas hai, kafi time hai, and don't worry, I'll try to make my short notes available to all of you. If you guys will be willing for it, I will try to make it available for all of you so that you can study everything at your own pace also from them. Okay. Today in my family, they didn't drink mother's milk because of some issue. They are so thin even now. So they are deficient with marasmus. Not necessarily, you know, there are some children who have some reasons why they can't drink mother's milk. For example, there can be allergic to mother's milk. There are children who are allergic to milk. Okay. Milk allergy is very common, in fact. And in that case, you know, they will be given carbohydrate and protein in some other form. Hai na, unko hum chambach se powder mein, you might have seen NutriShore, PediaShore, lot of these powders come. They are like a formula feed. So then they are given to these children who have deficiency. Can you explain diarrhea and constipation? Bilkul, kabz hai ek aur ek dast hai na, kabz and dast. So very simple principle. Just try to understand, this is your intestine. This is your intestine. What happens in diarrhea? First, let's try to see. In diarrhea, what is happening is, so there is a lot of water. There is a lot of water, and water is not being reabsorbed. So your small intestine and large intestine, they're supposed to take up water. So they are not absorbing water. There is reduced absorption. So that means a lot of water will be there. So that means you will have liquid feces and a lot of feces coming out because water is not being reabsorbed. Okay. Opposite happens in constipation. In constipation, either you are drinking too less water, or for some reason excess water is being reabsorbed. Water is reabsorbed. So there is no water. So that is why you will have very hard pellet like stools, dry hard stools, hai na? So they will be difficult to be passed. That is why it will be difficult to pass such stools. Okay, so basically in diarrhea the transit time is being decreased transit, which means that khana aata hai upar se aur jaldi niche se nikal jata hai. Transit ka time kam hai. Here there is increased transit, matlab bahut slow chal raha hai, theek hai? So diarrhea is like metro and this is like a passenger train. This is like a super fast nahi, this is like a slow passenger train, chuk chuk gaadi, right? That is the difference between these two things. Lots of causes of migraine, very difficult to explain migraine at this level. Ek tarike se aisa samajh lo, it's a headache which is very severe and it has a lot of other components. Why it happens is complex to understand. MBBS में आओगे तो there will be a lot of things to read on migraine, कौन सी drugs देते हैं, क्या होता है migraine, लड़कियों में होता है कि लड़कों में होता है, lot of things to read, okay? तो मैं जिस भी चीज़ की वैसे curiosity हो, you are always welcome to read it on Wikipedia. एक basic overview मिल जाएगा तुम्हें बहुत चीज़ों का, ठीक है? Clear to all of you. So that was all about today's session. I'll do a quick revision of everything we have done so far. I'll do a very quick revision of everything that we have done so far. Before that, I have to very quickly tell you about the Unacademy program. है ना? छोटा सा थोड़ा आपको बता देते हैं. तो NEET crash course आपको पता है हमने launch किया था. Until 5th March, it was highly discounted. It was available for only 89 rupees. Okay? Prices have increased for the same. Now the same crash course on public demand, it is back. And now the price is 300 and you can, it is still very affordable and you can use my referral code Chaitanya10 or Aims Delhi for the best discount on this crash course. You have the top educators teaching in this. Okay? And if you want to join the batches for NEET 2024 and NEET 2025, you can. These are the prices for them and you can use my referral code to get additional discount, that is 20% discount on these batches. Okay? So 2025 ke liye RM batch is starting on 12th April. And Lakshya batch is starting on 5th April. So if you are taking the individual batch, the price is less. If you are taking for subscription for 24 months, including all batches, then the price is slightly more, but then you get access to all educators. Okay. So Prarambh and Lakshya batch, we have some early bird discounts also. So early bird offer is 19,000 for Prarambh, which is for 2024. And for 2025, it is only 27,000. Again, top educators will be teaching you here and you can use my referral code. Chaitanya10. Please remember to utilize this referral code. Theek hai? And if you can also learn at the offline centers that are there in almost 40 cities now, and you can go to Kota also, but I was never a fan of Kota. It's totally up to you. For those who are appearing in NEET in 2023, we are doing a mega combat in which 100 participants will get Amazon vouchers up to rupees 250 each and even more. For the top winners, we have other prizes as well. So it will be a 45 minute test with 28 questions and you can appear in it since a lot of students will be giving this combat and you can use my referral code to enroll for this combat. Please remember to use my referral code Chaitanya10. Okay? And lastly, if you are wanting to take the test series which started on 26th February, you still have time, you can enroll. You will also get access to the previous test that you have missed and you can also use my referral code here for a 20% off. So this was all about the Unacademy subscription program. Now let's do a quick revision of the 5 points that we have covered so far. ठीक है, भैया एक बार pancreas वाली slide show कर दो. I'll quickly go through all the slides. Don't worry. ठीक है. Tanishka, ignore these people. है ना? अगर कोई बदतमीजी कर रहा है, strictly ignore them. No need to entertain such people. Let's start with the this point about I was just going to start. I'll share the PDF on Telegram so you can quickly scan this QR code if you haven't joined the Telegram channel. Yahan pe main update karta rahunga. Tomorrow again we will have our class at 10 PM and topic will be breathing and exchange of gases for tomorrow's class. And I hope you have watched my session on 8th that I have uploaded, which was about the NT update on syllabus. If you haven't seen this, please go ahead and do so and drop your wonderful comments. Right, so let's start with the 5-point revision in 2 minutes. Quickly, come on. Sab log pen niche rakh do aur suno meri baat. First point, human rendition. There are 3 important things Thecodont embedded in socket of jawbone. Diaphyodont, two sets of teeth, temporary and permanent. Heterodont means four different types of teeth. What is the formula in adult? Formula in adult is 2-1-2-3. What is the formula in a 17-year-old? Because there is no wisdom teeth, it is 2-1-2-2. And what about temporary dentition? It is 2-1-0-2. Okay. Second point, in stomach you have gastric glands which are having three types of cells: mucous neck cells releasing mucus, peptic cells which release pepsinogen, parietal cells which release two things, HCl and intrinsic factor. Intrinsic factor is required for vitamin B12 absorption. In intestine you have goblet cells which release mucus, and your mucus is also supplemented by bicarbonate from the pancreas which protects from acid from the stomach. Brunner's gland found in duodenum, they are special because they are not in mucosa, they are present in submucosa and they are also releasing mucus. The combined juice of intestine is called sucus entericus, which has a lot of enzymes like maltase, dipeptidase, lipase, nucleosidase. Okay. Next, coming to the next point that you have to know, that is about the various juices: bile juice, pancreatic juice and intestinal juice. Please remember, bile juice has no enzymes, only bile salts and bile pigments. Pancreatic juice has six components that you have to know. So this is the slide you can see: to digest carbohydrate, fat and protein. For carbohydrate it has pancreatic amylase, for fat it has pancreatic lipase, for protein it has trypsinogen, chymotrypsinogen and carboxypeptidase. The sixth enzyme is nuclease for digestion of DNA and RNA. How is the activation taking place? So trypsinogen is activated by enterokinase coming from the small intestine, and once trypsinogen is activated it activates all the other enzymes. Okay, so it is important to know enterokinase activates trypsinogen, right? Last, bile helps in emulsification of fats and activation of lipases. That is the third point. Fourth point, very important: mouth absorption of drugs to prevent heart attack. Some drugs. Stomach, remember, alcohol. Small intestine, almost everything is absorbed through the small intestine. What about large intestine? Some amount of water, some amount of minerals, some drugs. Theek hai? Which of the following are transported by osmosis? Water, facilitated diffusion, fructose. Active transport, glucose and amino acids along with sodium. Simple diffusion, glucose, amino acids and some electrolytes. What about fatty acids and glycerols? They are converted into micelles in the lumen. Then they are absorbed into the enterocytes. In the enterocytes, protein is added to the fat and it is converted to chylomicron. Chylomicron goes into the lacteals, which are lymph channels, and from there they are absorbed to the blood vessels. Last point, what are the diseases? Jaundice, vomiting, diarrhea, constipation, indigestion. You are almost aware of everything. Indigestion means there is improper digestion leading to feeling of fullness. Okay. Why can it occur? It can be due to inadequate enzyme, anxiety, food poisoning, overeating and spicy food. Okay. Protein energy malnutrition, it is of two types: kwashiorkor and marasmus. Kwashiorkor means only protein deficiency. Marasmus means calorie and protein deficiency, and it occurs in children less than 1 year of age jinhone maa ka doodh nahi piya. That is the funda, and with that we have covered NCRT in 5 lines. Okay, so this was the magic that I wanted to create for all of you, and I hope I have been able to do justice to what I said, that I will cover NCRT in 5 lines in 5 slides. See you guys tomorrow for a wonderful session on respiration in humans, that is human respiration, that is breathing and exchange of gases. Same time, 10 p.m. This time is okay with all of you? Is 10 p.m. okay with all of you? I hope there is no problem in the time of 10 p.m. It works for all of you. I hope everyone is comfortable with 10 p.m. Thank you so much guys for joining, and once I end the stream, I definitely want all of you to drop wonderful, beautiful comments on my video, because they definitely make my day, and मुझे भी ऐसा अच्छा लगता है कि तुम्हें actually सीखने को मिला मेरी class से. Thank you so much. Names and positions of all sphincters in human body. देखो, इस chapter में एक ही sphincter है जो important है, that is guarding the hepatopancreatic duct. The name of the sphincter is sphincter of Oddi. ठीक है, बाकी sphincters होते हैं sphincter of Boyden. ठीक है, बट वो सब इतने इंपॉर्टेंट नहीं है. तुम स्फिंक्टर ऑफ ओडाई याद रख लो, इट गार्ड्स द हिपेटोपैंक्रियाटिक डक्ट. मोस्ट लाइकली क्वेश्चन विल बी ऑन दैट ओनली. ठीक है, आई एम ग्लैड विद्या यू लाइक द सेशन. थैंक यू ईशानी, थैंक यू तनिष्का, थैंक यू अदम्या. रॉ पीनट्स. आई होप यू आर एबल टू एक बार दोबारा से सब्सक्राइब करके नोटिफिकेशंस यानी कि बेल आइकन दबा के देखो. आई होप यू शुड बी एबल टू गेट द नोटिफिकेशंस, है ना. दैट शुड नॉट आइडली हैपन बिकॉज आई वोंट वांट यू टू मिस आउट माय क्लासेस सिंस यू गाइज आर सो डियर टू मी. ठीक है, एनी अदर डाउट्स? इफ नन वी कैन प्रोसीड टू टुमारो. आई थिंक अदम्या यू हैड सम डाउट इन द लास्ट क्लास. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू क्लियर इन दिस क्लास यू कैन डू इट. ओके, डक्ट ऑफ विरसुंग बता दें. फिर तो सब कुछ ही बता देता हूँ, है ना. डक्ट ऑफ विरसुंग, डक्ट ऑफ सेंटोरिनी, सब कुछ बता दूँ. ओके, सो व्हाट आई विल डू इज आई विल पुट अ डायग्राम फ्रॉम माय शॉर्ट नोट्स फॉर ऑल ऑफ यू सो दैट आपकी कंफ्यूजन खत्म हो जाए मन से, है ना. तुम ये ना कहो कि मैंने बताया नहीं. ठीक है, तुम लोग पूछ रहे हो इसलिए बता रहा हूँ, अदरवाइज आई वुड नॉट हैव टोल्ड यू. जस्ट सी वेरी क्लियरली, इट इज़ वेरी इजी टू अंडरस्टैंड. स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द लिवर. ओके, फ्रॉम लिवर यू गेट हिपैटिक डक्ट्स. ओके, फ्रॉम गॉल ब्लैडर यू गेट सिस्टिक डक्ट. टुगेदर दे फॉर्म कॉमन बाइल डक्ट, ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज डक्टस कॉलिडोकस. ओके, वॉट इज गार्डिंग द बाइल डक्ट? बी फॉर बाइल, बी फॉर स्फिंक्टर ऑफ बॉयडन. स्फिंक्टर ऑफ बॉयडन, ऑल राइट. Now, this bile goes to the pancreas. From pancreas, you have main duct called as Virsung duct or main pancreatic duct. You have an accessory pancreatic duct which drains separately, that is called duct of Santorini. Okay? But Virsung duct and ductus cholecystocus, they combine to form hepatopancreatic duct which is dilated at its end. That dilation is called as ampulla of water. Okay, and it is guarded by the sphincter of Oddi. So, two sphincters, sphincter of Boyden and sphincter of Oddi. What are all the ducts? You can see ductus cholecystocus, cystic duct, hepatic ducts, common hepatic duct, hai na? Virsung duct, which is the main pancreatic duct, and accessory pancreatic duct called as the duct of Santorini. That is the structure. No trick, it is very, very simple. There are no names only. Matlab, it is just named on where it is coming from. Just try to, I'll make it simple for you. See, this is your liver. This is your liver, hai na? I'll make it very simple for you. This is your liver. Okay, your liver is divided into two parts. I hope you know, right and left lobe. Right lobe and left lobe. So right lobe gives the right hepatic duct. So this is the left lobe. This is the left hepatic duct. This is the right hepatic duct. So these two are ducts. Okay. So when left and right hepatic duct combine, what will be formed? Common hepatic duct. This is called common hepatic duct. Right now, gallbladder hasn't come into the picture. Next, gallbladder is there below the liver. So it will also give a duct called as cystic duct. It is giving a duct called as cystic duct. When common hepatic duct and cystic duct will combine, it will be called as ductus cholecystocus. That is called as ductus cholecystocus. Cholecystocus means bile. So ductus cholecystocus. And it is guarded by which sphincter? I told you B for bile, B for Boyden. So sphincter of Boyden is guarding this. Sphincter of Boyden. Okay, sphincter of Boyden. I am just writing in short. Sphincter of Boyden. Now there is pancreas. So pancreas has a main pancreatic duct. You just remember this main pancreatic duct, which is called the duct of Virsung. Together these two things combine. Together these two combine and they form the hepatopancreatic duct, which is dilated at its end called as ampulla of Vater. Right? Then there is a sphincter called as sphincter of Oddi, and through this they will enter the duodenum. Okay. Pancreas also has a minor pancreatic duct called as duct of Santorini, which goes directly to the duodenum. This is the funda. Okay? Ek do bar isi concept ko bar bar revise kar loge, sari ducts tumhe yaad rahengi. There will be absolutely no issue in remembering anything. Theek hai? I hope I have been able to clear your doubts and I have covered the entire chapter in 5 lines. So see you guys for my tomorrow session. Aoge sab log, promise karke jao कि कमेंट अच्छे करोगे इस वीडियो पे, और कल आप सब लोग आओगे फॉर माय सेशन ऑन ब्रीदिंग एंड एक्सचेंज ऑफ gases. I want to see you all. Time is again going to be the same. 10 p.m. we will hopefully start on time tomorrow. Okay? So I'll just quickly show you for tomorrow's session. Right, so this is the session for tomorrow. Tomorrow is 11th. This is the session for tomorrow. Clear with all of you? No doubts? Okay. ठीक है. Thank you Manju. Bye bye. Thank you Shani. Bye bye. अदम मैं बताओ तुम्हारा डाउट कहाँ गया यार. कुछ नहीं होता, मैं पूछ रहा था कि BDS इज अ गुड ऑप्शन. हाँ तो इसका सिंपल सा फंडा है. देखो BDS इज अ गुड ऑप्शन फ्रॉम अ गुड कॉलेज. ठीक है, मेरा तो ये फर्म बिलीफ है कि मीडियोकर कॉलेज से फर्स्ट थिंग इज योर पैशन. पैशन से ऊपर कुछ नहीं होता. ठीक है, अगर तुम्हारे पैशन में इतना फर्क है कि तुम्हें लगता है कि यार मुझे BDS नहीं करनी है, मैं तो MBBS ही करूँगा, मुझे दांत नहीं देखने हैं, then never do BDS because then you will never be happy with it. Okay, first अगर तुम्हारा passion इधर है और इधर नहीं है तो ये मत करना. ठीक है, very clear. First point is passion. Second point is पैसा. अगर तुम्हें पैसे से मतलब है, अगर तुम्हें पैसे से मतलब है और passion में इतना फर्क नहीं है तो let me tell you, money is almost equivalent in BDS. In fact, sometimes you can even earn more. Okay, so BDS में पैसे की कोई problem नहीं है. Right? Third thing I feel is college. अगर तुम्हें MBBS private college से करनी पड़ रही है, अगर MBBS तुम्हें private college से करनी पड़ रही है या तुम foreign जाके कर रहे हो, right? उससे better ये होगा कि अच्छे college, in fact MAMC से BDS कर लो, right? That will probably be better in the long run, especially if any of your parents or someone in the family is doing this. ठीक है, इसका बहुत advantage रहेगा. Okay? Is that clear? Adamya, I hope that clears your doubt. And thank you so much for asking this because I'm sure bahut students ke man mein ye doubt aata hai. They don't have anyone to guide them. So that is why I always tell you, don't call me sir. Call me Chaitanya. Treat me like your friend from AIIMS. Theek hai? I'm your friend from AIIMS. And whatever doubts you have, that can be academic, that can be non-academic, that can be related to what you want to do in life, I'm here to help you. Okay? So see you guys tomorrow. Lots of comments needed on this video and all the sessions on 5 important lines of NCRT. I have created a playlist. You guys can share that playlist with your friends. ठीक है? यार मेरे पास ना unfortunately moderator access नहीं है. I am, because as you can see, I am logged on from my personal account only. है ना? We don't have the access to the YouTube channel. So just ignore whoever is, you know, saying misogynist things or whatever. No need to pay attention to that. We will stay focused and I'll try to see what can be done. But educators don't have the access to the account. We are usually given the stream links and that is how it works. ठीक है, चलो. See you guys. Thank you so much all for joining in. सो जाओ तुम लोग भी, already 11:30 बज गए हैं, है ना? तो have a good night's sleep. See you guys tomorrow at 6.